from New York, six drink minimum, it's Late Night with David Letterman. Tonight, Marilu Henner, LL Cool J, and screenwriter Richard Price, plus Paul Schaefer and the world's most dangerous man. And now, Liz Taylor's favorite ex-husband, David Letterman.
Gentlemen, everything all right on camera three, Bailey? All right. How do you do, folks? Nice to have you with us. I sense maybe we have out-of-towners, tourists visiting New York City. Do we have some folks here? I thought I recognized a lone cry for help up there. This is fascinating. This city always amazes me because they're coming up with new and different ways to appeal to tourists. Beginning tomorrow, if you're from out of town and you're touring New York City, go down to Times Square for $5. They got a guy down there who will do for you for $5 your very own chalk body outline.
Fabulous. That's New York.
What a
fabulous deal.
Hey. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a show business celebrity birthday. Cher, our good friend Cher. to my way of thinking, and I've said this before, Cher is not just a performer, not just a fine actress, not just a talented singer. No. Cher is a national treasure. Cher today is 47 years old. 47 years old, celebrating her, yep. And I believe her face is five. A little something from the Cher song.
A little Cher, yeah.
Is that gypsies, tramps, and things?
Exactly.
How do I know
you
that?
You know. Man knows.
You know, I've made a lot of fun of Cher, made a lot of jokes, told a lot of silly things about Cher, but I really think when you consider Cher and her life and her career, you have to take your hat off to her, because to be Cher, she's had to pay, I think, a very, very high price. And most of that's labor. The haunting and lovely gypsies, tramps, and thieves.
Hey, kids, how you doing? Okay.
I found this fascinating. Earlier today, this came out of California. And stay with me. Maybe you heard about this, but it's a little complicated, so help me through this. A guy now has a job in California, and for 6 years, a woman who to him is superior on the job order chart there is allegedly sexually harassing the guy. So you see what that is? It's reverse of what the classic situation is in our society. A guy every day goes to work with the dread and the fear of being sexually tormented and harassed by his female superior.
Yeah.
So the guy files suit, and yesterday in a court in California, the man was awarded $1 million. The woman was found guilty of sexual harassment. The guy was given $1 million. Now,
man,
the reason I bring this up is, just in case maybe you're happen to be watching tonight, it's something to keep in mind, Jane Pauley. I do that because it goofs up my inner ear and I get really loopy.
Yeah!
Fine.
Hey!
This is the show, right?
Yes, sir.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Marilu Henner is on the program, a fine actress and a delightful woman. I thought I'd seen one of them dots crawling.
You're goofy.
Also on the big show, do you mind if I call it the big show? Also, the man writer says, no, go ahead. Good idea, call it the big show. I don't get that kind of encouragement from the staff. We got a guy. Call it the big show, Dave. Damn it, it's your show. Call it whatever the... LL Cool J on the program tonight, kid. This man can write you a terrifically entertaining book. This is a guy who wrote Clockers, among other things. I think Clockers was his most recent effort, and has written many screenplays of his films that have been blockbuster motion pictures.
Uh-huh.
A very fascinating man. Richard Price is on the program now. Mr. Paul Schaefer, right over there. Paul.
Hi, everybody. Hello out there in TV land, and hello, David. How are you, David?
Hey, how you doing?
Great.
How you doing? Nice to see you.
You too.
How's everything?
Man, swinging. Everything's swinging.
Is there a little extra special jolt of electricity in the air tonight?
Yeah, I feel it.
You know what it is? I think people are extra excited, or as we say back in Indiana, extra excited.
Why is that?
Well, tonight is the last night of the television program Cheers.
Oh, tonight is.
Yeah, I know. Ladies and gentlemen, please try to deal with your grief. Form support groups. Meet together in church basements and work through this, all right? Last episode of Cheers, the program, first one on the air in 1935.
That long ago.
Cheers. And tonight they said goodbye, they called it quits, they wrapped it up, they bet adieu.
Bet adieu, you know?
And now they're gone. They're history. They're a ghost. They're in a cab. They're 86. They're gone. Vapor. Kiss them goodbye. The cast, the lovable cast of Cheers. And also, I think they, didn't they take Seinfeld with them?
Did they?
I think he's gone, too.
That would be too bad.
Yeah, I think they took really? Out several shows. But anyway, as always, a salute, a tip of the hat to a job well done to the folks there at Cheers.
Oh, really, that's nice of you.
I myself personally don't drink.
You do not? I'm aware
of
that.
I haven't had anything to drink in 11 years.
So if you went into a bar like the Cheers bar...
I wouldn't be going into a bar.
No, you don't.
I just wouldn't go into a bar.
Don't even bother going in.
But I'm telling you, when I drank, whoa! Yow! I would drink enough for like 8 guys.
Uh-huh.
But I stopped. I don't drink anymore.
Well, you had enough.
And I feel better. You know, I feel much better. I can't tell you how pleasantly surprised I was the first morning I woke up without a hangover.
Right.
It's kind of like, what's missing? Oh, yeah, that annoying buzz in my head is gone.
Well, that's
how are we doing on time?
3 minutes.
Oh, geez, 3 minutes? Oh, wow. Hey, happy birthday, Bob. I know what we can do. Paul.
Yeah.
Did you bring in the baby pictures?
I have some baby pictures.
Six weeks ago, Paul Schaefer and his beautiful wife Kathy had a brand new baby girl, and I believe this is the first time we've seen the photos
these
on the show.
These are the first. Yes.
All right.
I'm thrilled about these, and it's great that
if
we.
If you
have
don't
a little,
want to, I understand. I don't want to put you on the spot.
A little extra time.
Okay.
That I can show them. This is her name is Victoria here.
Right.
Here she is. This was taken a couple of weeks ago. Isn't she cute?
She's beautiful.
There she is.
She's a beautiful baby. Yeah.
Now. She loves this. This is one we took last weekend.
Oh. And she's probably giggling
and
there?
She loves when I hold her up in the air. And then just last night, we took this one.
Wow, what is that?
Isn't that? Wait a minute.
We didn't see it.
Yes, there. We took this one just the other day. So she is really...
The baby is actually lifting you?
Well developed for her age.
Wow, that's...
You can see that.
Don't be careful if you don't let her overdo it.
No, I know.
It seems like it might be just a little too much for baby to be lifting.
Well, you know, she got a kick out of doing it.
Okay. Huh? Hal, we have a couple of seconds here. Let's try on some goofy mustaches, all right? Just try on one or two. See what you think of that. Yeah, growing right out of my nose. That's pretty pleasant. I tell you what, I can do something to kill some time. When I was in the... Let me borrow these cards, Tony. Let's see. These are just regular cue cards.
Yes, sir.
They're made out of cardboard.
Yes, sir.
They come from trees, right? It's a paper product.
That's right.
Thank you very much, Tony. Now watch this. I don't know, you've probably seen this. Almost any good magician can do this, but this is something that I learned in the Navy. All right, you just roll that up, and then I just...
Roll
it
up.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, what I have to do is I'm going to kind of telescope them together, and then you get as many in that configuration as you possibly can.
It was in the Navy.
All right, now. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. Oh, look what you can make. Have a seat.
Thank you.
That's great. You know what I can do? Sometimes if I concentrate really hard, I get the head of Shelley Duvall to give me lotto picks. Here we go. Let's
That'd
try.
That'd be fun.
Here, is she coming? Here she
is. Massachusetts Megabucks. How about 5, 11, 23, 24, 29, 37.
Great. Wow. Okay, I'll be sure to play that one. All right, so 1 minute.
1 minute left.
1 minute. You know, a sports blooper, that's exactly what we need now. I'll get you Marv Albert, ladies and gentlemen. NBC Sports. I think he might be in the hall.
Really?
I saw him earlier trying to get change out of the vending machine. Marv Albert, come on in. Marv, nice to see you. Robert,
what is
that? What was that? Well, no, you grabbed it. You know what you did. Stop it.
From the world of...
A sports blooper.
Ready? From the world of the wild and the wacky, Hal worked out this very subtle cue. Roll it, Hal. Here it is. From the wild and the wacky, Otis Nixon with a little pop fly down the line. Here comes Ken Caminiti of the Houston...
Oh my God!
Look out!
Oh, my God!
And there you have it. From the wild...
Robert, ladies and gentlemen. You know what we have some time for?
What?
This might be fun. Let's see if we can't guess Larry Bud Melman's weight. This, if we have time, because we could get some scales here, it'd be fun to have Larry on the program. We put him on the scales, and we just guess his weight. That's what we'll do. We'll just kill some time by having Larry on the scales. We guess his weight. All right. We all set?
Yeah.
Here we go. We're going to try and guess Larry Bud Melman's weight. On the scales.
£172.
Yeah.
And I'd be happy to kick your ass. So long, suckers.
Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. We should be right back on time, shouldn't we? I think we are. We'll do a commercial. We'll be right back.
If America had never invented rock and roll, chances are it'd be something like this. Fortunately, we did.
Genuine draft rusty on a stock car. See it. Hear it. Feel it. Catch it if you can.
Thousands of bike accessories are on sale now during Cyclomania at Yakima Schwinn Cycling and Fitness. Bike stuff like pumps, $29.99, headlights, $18.99, body stuff like youth bell helmets, $19.99, and bike shorts are $5 off. In the bargain basement, inner tubes are 99 cents and baby seats from $5. The Hollywood bike carrier is just $39.99. Shop Cyclomania at Yakima Schwinn Cycling and Fitness, 507 West Knob Hill Boulevard.
You know, I forgot. Now I know what the problem is. It's because it's Bob's birthday. There was no rehearsal today.
Ah, well.
We canceled the rehearsal to celebrate Bob's birthday.
Everybody's celebrating.
Bob's biggest dream in life is to get stand-in work for Don Johnson. That's Bob's biggest
dream. Now that you mention
that's
it.
Biggest dream in life.
Now that you mention it, I can see why.
Hey, on the program this evening, Marilu Henner will be out here a little bit later. LL Cool J will be on the show. And writer Richard Price. That's a pretty good show, don't you think?
Jam-packed.
What the hell else do you want in a big TV show? Do you mind if I call it the big TV show?
No.
Go ahead, Dave. It's your show. You call it.
Let's do our top 10 list and then pack up and go home early tonight.
Hey, I thought you made a chair out of those.
I didn't get a chance to finish the footstool. And if we have time later, more funny mustaches.
One was great. There's one.
Oh, hey, that's nice. Shoulder pads, close enough. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the category for tonight's top 10 list, listen clearly, carefully, as I announce it to you. From the home office in Oneonta, New York, top 10 signs your husband is a loser. If you have the slightest hint, hunch, clue, or feeling that your husband is a loser, listen carefully. Here we go. Top 10 signs now that the man you married may in fact be a loser. Oh, he's wearing phony mustaches. That would be a tip-off, right? Phony electronically generated mustaches.
Hey, don't give anything away.
If your husband looks like this...
That's a loser.
Now we're having fun.
Phony electronically generated.
We turned a costly production error into good, clean American TV fun. That's like that.
That's the magic.
That's why they call it the big show. Here we go. Top 10 signs your husband's a loser. Number 10, shirt is never tucked in completely or untucked. Number 9, moves his lips when he watches TV. Number 8, keeps leaning over to ask question about the Ernest movie. Number 7, always quoting Urkel. Number 6, nobody called him Mr. Vice President in 4 months. Number 5, Number five, your wedding ring looks a lot like a greasy washer. Number four, among tapes in his permanent video library, all the Bud Bowls. Number three, spends hours a day inside a Mickey Mouse suit and doesn't even work for Disney. Well, that is a little odd. Number two, his teenage girlfriend shoots you in the head. Yep. Right there, that's worth the price of admission, right, isn't it? And the number one sign, your husband is a loser. Sex is awkward wearing E.T. pajamas. There you go. That's an old Beatles tune, ain't it?
That is correct, sir.
Absolutely. what's the matter? You fell out of your chair, didn't you? Maybe you should get right back in the chair. Have you ever tried those rubber thumbs? They're wonderful. It increases your grip. Try them, seriously. Get yourself a set of rubber thumbs. Yeah, one set will last like a year, frankly. With nothing to promote, we've invited our first guest here for one reason alone, a cheap excuse for me to enjoy a prolonged hug. Here she is, ladies and gentlemen, the always lovely Mary Lou Henner. Mary Lou! May I make you a cardboard chair?
Please. I'll take a pillow.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, too.
How you been?
Good. I've been hanging out in New York. I mean, my husband and I have a production company.
What's your husband's name?
Robert Lieberman.
Robert Lieberman? Oh, Bob Lieberman, sure.
Well, he used to be called Bob in grammar school.
And you know, I went to high school with a Bob Lieberman.
There are a few of them.
Yeah.
But I'm only married to one. I mean, he knows about six people.
That's
with
not what I've heard.
Whoa.
All right, so you're in New York City.
No, we just sold a series to CBS.
What kind
Am
of
I
series?
Am I allowed to say that?
I don't know, just say whatever you want.
Oh, okay. You are so much fun tonight.
Yeah,
I can't believe it.
Yeah.
I mean, let's throw away those notes and just...
My inner ear is out of whack.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
No, you want to know what's the best thing for that?
What's that?
Whenever you're having some kind of motion sickness, this is on an airplane, on a boat, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
You get an umeboshi plum from a...
umeboshi plum
from a health food store.
Right.
It's this incredible Japanese salt plum. I don't know if anybody knows
about it. Ask for it by name.
Umeboshi plum. No, it's like a Japanese aspirin. I mean, if you're hungover, if you're having digestion problems, whatever, this is like the best thing to take. But for motion sickness, what you're supposed to do is you tape it to your belly button.
Oh, please, come on.
No, but it works.
Oh, please. I don't care.
It works. Turbulence in an airplane? Honestly, it's incredible.
Now, how can it possibly work? Explain to me the chemical, physiological interaction that would cause that to happen.
It's the great balancer. It balances everything.
That's not true.
No, it is. David, you may not have known this.
Well, let me tell you the only thing that has ever worked for me, and I've sailed around this, I've sailed
like
the planet.
Like scopolamine or something?
No,
ear?
The only thing, you know when you just get where your lips are vibrating and it's just...
That's called sex.
Yeah, no.
That.
I know, but
you know what? I'm really upset.
When you're that sick, the only thing that'll cure it, and I've done it, and my family has done it, the only thing that's going to take care of you,
what?
Fudge.
Fudge? That's such an Indiana thing. Indiana. I can't believe it.
Oh, man. What are we going to talk about? What else is new with you? You got to...
I'm writing a book. I'm doing another video. I'm doing a movie. You know, all those stuff.
You've got this book you've been writing for like 8 years.
I know. Well, I've been living a little bit longer. No. I've been writing it actually for a year.
What kind of book is it?
It's kind of a life story thing, autobiographical, but it's also all my theories. Mm-hmm. You know, the stuff that I talk about on your show.
Is that what people want, do you think?
God, I hope so.
Yeah.
I'm talking about the first time that I met you. You know?
Oh, really? I'm in the book?
You're in the book.
Wow, cool.
You're in the book.
Yeah?
You're Stern book. You know what? You could have really had a whole chapter.
Oh.
Why didn't you ask me out back then?
I didn't know I was supposed to. I know what it was. I was discouraged by the line. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. That's very sweet of you.
No, it was 1979.
You know what? You thought it was 1982. I happen to know from the notes that you thought it was 1982.
Doesn't make any difference.
That was my first time here. But it was. It was 1979. Who were your other guests? I bet you don't remember that.
My volunteer fireman buddies?
No. It wasn't this show.
No, it was up at the house, wasn't it?
No, I've never seen your house. Wait a minute, I want to know something. How come Arsenio's done 1,000 and you've done 1,796 shows?
He
and
can't
you've been
count.
On
four- he can't count.
I mean, okay. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
I mean, it's just
nice,
so odd.
He's a nice guy, very talented, very funny. He just can't count.
Oh, I mean, it just seems strange. I saw that on the sheet of paper back
there. Yeah, I know.
I
People make up all kinds of facts and figures and statistics and so forth. But it's we've done, like, when we're finished here, we will have done 46,000 shows.
You just wanted to sound younger, right? Not like you've beaten
what
everything.
What are we doing today. Here?
Commercial.
We have to do a commercial.
Already?
Yeah, we
haven't gotten to, like,
haven't
any of the
any.
Notes.
It's a beautiful dress. Very, very sophisticated. Very,
thank
very,
you,
very, very cool looking. Very nice.
Well, after, go ahead.
Yeah, what?
I'll
go
finish
ahead,
my story later. That's okay, never mind.
Yeah, is it a good story?
I'll work on it during the commercial.
All right. Do you need paper and pencil? We'd like to see all your work,
no.
too, when you're finished.
I'll get it.
We'll be back here after this commercial with Mary Lou Henner.
What does it take to be a mountain man? Do you need a big horse? Do you need a deep tan? Do you have to have a saddle? Do you have to have a gear? Well, the simple truth is you just gotta have the beer.
Bush beer, an easy drinking Bush Light. Have you got what it takes to be a mountain man?
What does it take to live a mountain man's life? Get smooth Bush beer, easy drinking Bush Light.
Just plain soap until it chemically reacts with water and dries to a dull waxy film that clings to every bathroom surface. It's soap scum and it's very hard to get rid of. Or was. Introducing new Tilex soap scum remover. It's formulated specifically to dissolve soap scum on contact. Just spray it on and wipe it off to get your whole bathroom scum free. New Tilex soap scum remover. The sure way to wipe out soap scum.
Dear Saturn team members, my name is Judith Reiswig, and I'm a third grade teacher. After reading the Time magazine article, I decided my new car would be a Saturn. I liked the whole idea of what Saturn was about. It's one of those things I try to instill in my kids. Now, to let you know who you are building that Saturn with the blue-green exterior for, I'm enclosing my school picture. I'm sure if everything I've read is true, I won't be disappointed.
We all learn following distances in order to stop properly to get our driver's license, but do you remember them? Here's a more helpful rule, the two-second rule. Always allow at least 2 seconds between your vehicle and the vehicle in front of you. When the car in front of you passes a measuring point, like a road sign, count 1001, 1002, before you reach that spot. Now allow a little extra space, and you've given yourself a safe following distance.
Mary Lou Henner is here, LL Cool J is here, and also Richard Price.
You know, I was in a movie that Richard Price wrote.
Which
I
one?
I did a film called Blood Brothers with yeah? Richard Gere years ago.
Yeah, mm-hmm. He's great. Have you read any of his books?
No.
Yeah, he's very entertaining.
The one I was in.
Well,
yes, I should. Yeah. I'm more of a nonfiction reader.
That's all right.
But yeah, I should start reading more.
Did I mention everybody else who was on the big show here tonight?
Yes, you've beaten that one to death.
Oh, stop it. What else is, do we want to talk more about
well,
this
wanna,
book?
You know, I want to try some of my theories out on you because I seem to, like, discuss them with you and then they become, you know, enhanced. And that's why I have to give you credit.
These are things that you live by.
Things that I live by, yes.
Personal credos.
Personal credos. Like, there's the Goldilocks theory.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the Goldilocks theory is every girl is looking for her baby bear relationship.
Hmm.
That everything she does, the first relationship is to is one kind of relationship, that's to this. Then the second one is to that, to balance that first one. And the third one she's looking for, the baby bear, is just right.
Oh, I see. I see.
Right. Okay, then you have your theory of every other.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, let's say you have an appearance, like my last appearance was really great, so then the next time it's not going to be that good. You know, it's like you have an image of what...
You can prove this about your last appearance.
That's right. I'm working on this theory. I'm like fine-tuning it. No, it's like the theory of every other, is, and people will understand this later on in their life, maybe. But, you know, you have some experience and you have a viewpoint about it. Then you go, then the next time you see it or you relive that experience, you say, let's say you have an appearance and you say, oh, I was terrible, I was awful. Then you watch and you go, no, that wasn't so bad. Mm-hmm. And the next time you see it, you say, oh, God, no, I was terrible.
Right, right.
All right, so it's like the theory of every other. Every other experience is good and the opposites are bad.
And is one more true than the other?
No, because you're
They're equally valid.
They're equally valid, because it's the same appearance.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's the same thing. I mean, okay, all right, that one we're going to scratch from the book. Okay. Now let's talk about the yay-boo theory.
The yay-boo theory.
Now, you'll understand this coming from the Midwest. Uh-huh. You know how people from the Midwest grow up with parents who say things like, hey, kids, we're going to Florida, yay, but we can't go till next year, boo, but we can stay for 2 weeks, yay, but we'll have to stay in a crummy hotel, boo, but, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, it's the yay-boo theory.
Right.
Well, that maybe kind of works.
But how can we apply this to a better existence for all?
Well, I'm just commenting on what your life really is.
Uh-huh. Oh, I see.
Your life already is like this.
Yeah.
I'm just putting a title to it, or I'm putting like a saying to it or something. Or
you're sort of captioning.
I'm captioning. I'm the
you're
bottom
sort of
line
underlying.
Kind of person.
I see.
Right.
These aren't theories you're suggesting people look for and cultivate in their everyday lives.
Oh, no, not at all. This is what actually happens, and I'm putting a little title. It's like the men's bullseye theory. Okay, like the bullseye theory. Okay, men are more goal-oriented. Women are more process-oriented.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like in sex, too, right?
I don't know.
DJ, you should have asked me out years ago. You know exactly what I was talking about. No, men are more goal-oriented. Women are more process-oriented. You don't think so?
Well, I don't know. See, I can't possibly make that assessment because it would sound coming from...
Okay, it would sound sexist.
Yeah.
It would sound, you know, and after you trash Cher, God forbid you be sexist tonight.
You know, I am going to burn in hell for those remarks.
I don't think so. Okay, so men like, you know, and so men have a tendency to think that when a man is in the bullseye of his career, that he's, you know, the best at his job, then he's also, this is just a theory, that he's also the best father, the best lover, the best husband, the best sports person.
Right.
You know, whereas women sort of look at somebody who is in the best position and they'll say, oh, well, she can't be a good mother or she can't be happy or something like that. Does that sound sexy?
Yeah, I don't know.
It does, huh?
I don't know. I'm barely paying attention.
You're going to get, this alone is going to get a chapter in the book.
You know what I don't understand? Maybe you can help me out with this.
What?
Every time it gets windy, my cable goes on the blink.
That happens in L.A. too.
Why is that? The cable is buried 4 feet under the ground.
Because of animals under the ground.
The wind affects the animals and they say, let's go down and screw with Dave's cable.
That's what it is. They loosen it up, they burl around it, and then it's loose. It's like, this is why you shouldn't wear a hat when you're working out, because the little hair follicles, you lose more hair if you wear a
is
hat.
Right?
Yeah, because you're sweating, and the follicle gets, you know, wet, and it yanks out.
I'm not saying anything.
Just be nice.
All right.
This is my last time on the show in this form.
I hope you come with us to the new program at CBS.
Well, I hope so, too.
You're on CBS.
Yes.
Like, I guess you didn't know that, did you?
They signed the checks.
Wouldn't it be funny if you accidentally came across your name in TV Guide one day? I'll be damned. I got a show on CBS.
That's right.
Are you pushing anything? Selling anything?
I just sold a series.
Oh,
I'm doing
series,
a movie called Chasers with Tom Berenger and Dennis Hopper. But, you know, we just like to come on and play around.
I certainly appreciate it.
I really came on for Morty's birthday.
Oh, boy. Have a lovely summer. It's Mary Lou Henner.
From Hollywood Pictures, the Mario Brothers are out to rescue a kidnapped princess.
You better not hurt her!
Who will take them out of this world into another dimension. Where are we?
Yes!
Luigi!
Get him!
Are you all right?
Super Mario Brothers. This ain't no game. Rated PG. Starts Friday, May 28th. A night for Excedrin PM.
Why can't I turn off this day?
Daddy said I can't.
You're late.
No receipt, no refund.
My head aches and I can't sleep.
You want Excedrin PM. Strong aspirin-free headache medicine you can feel good about, plus a gentle ingredient to help you sleep.
They're sending me to Paris. Alone.
Turn off the day with Excedrin PM and rest assured it's aspirin-free.
One of the most important things I do around here. First, I want to know what kind of experience you got. All right. Now, why should I give you the job? Okay, how much money are we talking, including the four-wheel drive? So, when can you start?
Depression is a serious illness that's more than just the blues. Sometimes persons suffering from depression need support from friends and loved ones to get help from caring professionals. Once depression is diagnosed, treatment is fast and effective. Learn more about depression. Call today for a free brochure. 1-800-421-4211.
The Gorge at George Washington is proud to announce a seventh season of Premier Entertainment, presented from our breathtaking Central Washington location. Just look at this unforgettable lineup. All shows conveniently scheduled on weekends. Tickets go on sale Saturday, May 15th, 9 a.m. at all Ticketmaster outlets, or charge by phone at 206-628-0888. That number again, 206-628-0888. Produced by MCA Concerts Northwest.
Draft beers. You know, some of them are nothing more than rough drafts. So you gotta ask yourself, is your draft as good as Golden? Introducing Golden Draft from Michelob. The only one cold-filtered and cold-finished in the tradition of Michelob for a smooth draft taste. So if perfection is what you're looking for in a draft beer, don't stop at a rough draft. Start holding the Golden.
Just tell me this. Where's it written that it's cool to chew? I see these guys around with big, disgusting wads of goo in their mouth, and they have to, you know, spit. Nasty! What are they thinking? Smokeless tobacco is no more safe than cigarettes. Plus, it's filthy, sloppy, and it looks totally stupid. Any guy who chews is off my list, completely.
You're watching KNDO Channel 23, Yakima.
Gentlemen, tomorrow on the program, Will Smith will be on the show. You know what? He's got his own show. Will Smith. He's the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Yep. He'll be here tomorrow.
Lovely kid.
Also, Bruce Hornsby.
Ah.
Yep. Hey, what's come back? See if you can't get a sitter and come back. And also, Marv Albert will be on the program.
Oh, he'll be back. Great.
I love Marv. I am always so psyched. When Marv Albert...
We had a little teaser tonight.
Exactly. A little taste of Marv.
Tomorrow.
Coincidentally, that's the name of his restaurant he opened up downtown.
Taste of Marv.
A little taste of Marv.
A little taste of...
We need to do a commercial when we come back. LL Cool J will join us.
Experience the wildest thrill ride of the year. A white-knuckle action adventure. The adrenaline rush of the summer. Pure high energy excitement. Hang on for the ultimate adventure.
Starts Friday, mate.
Time is running out for La Hatz Jewelry's going out of business sale. La Hatz has taken additional markdowns on their entire $500,000 inventory. Diamonds, colored gemstone jewelry, all must be liquidated immediately. La Hatz has slashed prices on diamond wedding sets, Seiko and Citizen watches, giftware, and more. You'll find incredible savings, up to 70% off on the Valley's largest selection of fine jewelry. But you must hurry. Time is running out. Come in today to La Hatz Jewelry going out of business sale in Brosser.
For people with epilepsy, things have changed. They're reaching new heights, traveling new roads, swinging for the fences. But some still need more help. The Epilepsy Foundation of America is here to help. Let's not leave anybody out of life.
Caught in an endless time loop.
We could have been trapped here for hours, days, maybe years.
Unable to remember the past.
How did it happen? How did we get there?
A starship collision lies dead ahead.
We have to get out of here now.
Can the crew escape their own destiny?
Casualty reports coming in from all over the ship.
Or will time tick towards their final hour?
All hands abandon ship!
On Star Trek, The Next Generation.
Watch this Friday night at 6.
If you're 200 pounds, a drink like this may not affect you. If you're 110 pounds, it could make you too drunk to drive. Imagine if you're only 5 ounces. If you're pregnant, stop drinking. If you can't, call for help.
Hey, ho!
Welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Our next guest is certainly one of the most successful acts in the history of rap music. I have here a copy of the newest album entitled 14 Shots to the Dome. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the program LL Cool J. All right!
Yeah. We're gonna fuck this up. Put your hands in the air from side to side. And I'm gonna tell you a little story. And it goes like this here. Pink cookies in a plastic bag. Getting crushed by buildings. Pink cookies in a plastic bag. Getting crushed by buildings. I take 30 electric chairs and put them in a classroom. 30 MCs and set them free from their doom. It's like a tomahawk cuts through the wind when we begin. The wheel of fortune, it spins, holding the rhythm like elastic, molding your whole body like plastic. So why try to deny what you already know you love up above? Cause a mania hysteria in the streets. While your lovers get merrier in the sheets. I met this lady named Sweet Young Thing, and she gave me that feeling that sunshine bringing. Portable, sportable, totally affordable. Silky smooth, voice was real audible. I said, you're cool as Ice Cuba. She said, you're the public enemy I seen on the tuba. Nah, I'm like your uncle, baby. The style of your beautiful face drives me crazy. Play me like Big Daddy. I know your tribe, I called and requested for you to be manifested. She said, you know the same gang, I'ma flavor you the two. I said, you only knew the certain things I wanna do to you. Rub you down with warm iced tea, make you feel brand new, be in instantly. Boogie down and check this production. Give me them lips, they look good for suction. You're jingling, you're from around the way. I like your earrings, two L's, but anyway. Your granddaddy is here to spread cheer. Something nice and smooth with my tongue in your ear. Give me a snack, some salt and pepper on a burger. Ice cream, tea, or if you prefer the taste the honey, kid, ride in my Capri. And that's the joint, they got the real clear CD in. She said stars couldn't get me in a car. I don't know what type of man you are. You might know karate, do me a get away. I got a glimpse of your license plate, NWA. Cookies in a plastic bag, getting crushed by buildings. Now this is how the story goes like this here.
Getting crushed by buildings.
She was chubby and ready to rockin', naughty by nature and part of my private stocking. Riding in the relaxed frame of mind. Hammer timing, incredible. So edible and unforgettable. Soft like a Q-tip, I'd love to get with you. Cause I'm the type of guy that got props to. Feeling it more and more. When I get ready for a showcase put together well, I go deep and have an oil well show and tell. I said, yo, yo, you're so intelligent and elegant. I never run the BD with another MC. I got what I want right in front of me. I know a kid named K, he's a MD. Last time I heard Joe was getting real friendly. Belly to belly and chest to chest, thigh by thigh, leg by leg, and I guess nastified and all funkified. Come on, come on, come on, ride. Take it here, never fear. What you hear is a clear understanding of your big rear. And I will appear, my dear, with a beer and bags full of cheer. The waterbed, yeah, cause I rumble and groan. She said you gotta be bad to make the money moan. Ain't no reason to front on the way of life's shown. Oh yeah, I will jump in your bones like a grand master in a flash. Put out your cigarette and rest your tired ash. All I wanna do is make whoopee on my pink cookie. Not a rookie, when you take it off, I love a lookie. Cause I'ma mix it up tour style. Peace out, you got the sexual profile. Pink cookies in a plastic bag, getting crushed by buildings. Pink cookies in a plastic bag, getting crushed by buildings.
Dear Saturn team members, my name is Judith Reiswig, and I'm a third grade teacher. After reading the Time magazine article, I decided my new car would be a Saturn. I liked the whole idea of what Saturn was about. It's one of those things I try to instill in my kids. Now, to let you know who you are building that Saturn with the blue-green exterior for, I'm enclosing my school picture. I'm sure if everything I've read is true, I won't be disappointed.
They're in our homes, our hallways, our elevators.
Welcome to 113. You'll like it here.
But now they're in the most frightening place of all, our fantasies.
You watch these people?
Somebody's watching you like you watched them?
What do you mean you saw us?
We know every movie makes.
It's like playing God.
It's better.
Sharon Stone, William Baldwin, Tom Berenger. Sliver, rated R. Starts Friday, May 21st at theaters everywhere.
La la la, la la la.
Why is it always the same old story? Why ask why? Try a less filling beer with a lot more taste. Bud Dry. When it comes to a great beer, we wrote the book.
Next guest is a novelist and an Academy Award nominated screenwriter whose latest book, this is a great idea for a book. It's three screenplays, and these are the screenplays from big blockbuster motion pictures that this man has been responsible for. This will be available in June. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Richard Price. Richard! You're open for a stand-in work for Don Johnson, too, aren't you?
I shaved. What are you talking about?
Well, it's the T-shirt and the jacket, you know? No. The old Armani Miami.
My shirts are dirty.
Nice to see you. Now, this book does not contain... What is not included in this? Yeah.
You tell me.
It's the Bill Murray, Robert De Niro movie...
Mad Dog and Glory.
Yeah. Yeah. How come that's not in there?
Well, but when this book went to print, the movie wasn't released yet. I mean, it took a long time to get that movie out. And part of the problem was we were looking for the right director.
Right.
And I was also a producer on that movie. And
well, what does that mean? Do you know what you're doing as a producer?
Oh, absolutely not. That's why the studio wanted me. You know, so they could, you know... It's like Queen Elizabeth ruling England. You know, yeah. You get the hat and the check, you know. And
good gig.
But one of my jobs was to, you know, talk with different directors, and one of the guys I talked to was Ron Howard.
Opie.
Yeah.
Andy of Mayberry. We watched him grow up on TV, and now a fine director in his own right.
Yeah, well, we took them around. The movie involves evidence detectives, guys who go to murders and photograph the bodies and take fingerprints. And so I took them to the real crime scene unit in New York, and here he is, this like 6 foot tall Opie walking in, and all these detectives, you know, the hard bitten detectives, they look at this guy, and you can see it in their eyes. They're saying, "Opie's here." They're all excited.
That's just what I did.
What cops like to do is, they, you know, like the gas stations and restaurants give out, you know, matchbooks. Cops like to give out T-shirts with their unit on it. Uh-huh. So the first thing they do is they throw them a T-shirt, they give them a hat, and then they make them watch these slides of murders, you know, which they keep for, you know, homicide school or something.
I think Aunt B used to do the same thing when he was bad.
Those were photos.
Oh.
This is the carousel of death.
Oh,
and,
Lord.
You know, they try to be nice to the guy, so they're showing him all these...
They want to impress him. They want to make him feel at home.
Right. It's like, you're welcome to our thing. So he's watching this slideshow where it's like, you know, death by antler, death by samurai sword, death by... gee, I didn't know the body could be on the floor and the third floor, too.
Oh!
And it's connected. It's great the way it's connected. And he's getting greener and greener. And, you know, to them, this is like, you know, nothing. And they keep going on and on, and all of a sudden, they start leaving the room, and they tap him on the shoulder, and they say, "Just talk to my wife.
Yeah.
She doesn't believe you're here."
They're excited that he's there.
Yeah, so he's there, and he's watching, you know, death by blunderbuss and saying, no, really, it's me. Yeah, Andy's fine, you know, Bonnie's fine, really, click, click. Now, it's like the Jackie Vernon show.
When you guys would go out to crime scenes, would you actually be on the side of a crime?
We had to sit around and wait for somebody to get killed, and it happens in New York, so. We wound up going to, somebody got killed in a grocery in the roughest precinct in the five boroughs. And we're walking in, and here comes Ron Howard, you know, Opie with a crime scene unit hat.
Yeah,
all the local detectives, they're the toughest. We've got the highest homicide rate in the city. And they're trying to look real, like, wooden. And they know it's Ron Howard, and they're trying to ignore him. And they're processing the body. They're flipping it over, and they're going through all the stuff, and they're photographing the wounds. And nobody's looking at him. And all of a sudden, one of the detectives starts going, da 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 da. And it's like he had no idea he was doing it. And all of a sudden, Ron Howard turns to me and he says, "The fireman did the same thing."
He did.
And actually, then what happened is, then as they're photographing the body, and they're all being like this, you know, hard guy thing, all of a sudden they turn to him and say, "Ron, could you stand with my partner there for a minute?" And they move him over the body, and he's shaking hands under a sign that says, "Forget the dog, beware of owner."
Uh-huh.
It's like a hunting photo. And he's getting green and greener, and the next day I got a message on my machine. He said, "Please don't take this the wrong way, but I had a wonderful evening."
and he decided he didn't want to direct the movie based on that, or other considerations? Whatever it was. What did you do before you started becoming successful selling your books?
Well, not much. I was a Fuller Brush man. That's enough about that.
Are there really Fuller Brush men still working?
I was a Fuller Brush boy. I was 16.
trying to work your way up to the bigs.
Yeah, and I had the only professional job I had. I was teaching English as a second language in the Bronx at a community college, and I was teaching it at Newark Airport. And most of my students were
departing for the old country, or what?
No, they were coming to the new country, and I was supposed to be teaching them English. But I was the worst teacher in the world, and all I knew to teach them was the three twos, the difference between T-O, T-O-O, and T-W-O. And every time, like, somebody from the faculty came in to, analyze my performance in there, I gave them this begging look, "It's time for the three twos," you know, and they said, "All right, you got it. And they all looked really interesting. They all had to write sentences like, "I am going to the bathroom two to do number two," you know. And everybody said, "Oh, we get it now. TWO means something." Okay, thank you, Richard, you know.
And that was it. Yeah. And then you sold a book. And,
I had to after that.
Yeah. And then did you go back to your class after you had sold the book?
Well, what happened is at Newark Airport one time, they had me in a room. The range of level of English accomplishment in that class ranged from a guy who could barely speak his own native language to a guy who had a telescope importing firm in Buenos Aires and was embezzled on and spoke English better than I did. And they were sitting next to each other. I just kept flipping out handbooks to each other, and I just cracked. And I walked to a payphone about a mile away from the airplane hangar where I was teaching, and I called up the chairman of the board of Houghton Mifflin and said, "Do you have a book of mine? My name is Richard Price. It's called The Wanderers. Do you want it or not? If you don't want to give it back to me, hurry up." He says, "All right, wait, hang on a second." And he had me on hold for about 30 seconds, and he came on. And he said, "Oh, we'll take it." I said, "How much?" He said, $4,000. I said, "You got it." Hung up the phone, walked back in the rain, went to the class, and I said, "Io quitto." yo quitiero. Quito mio io. And I just...
Adios. Welcome. Blew right off. Let's pause here for a commercial, and then we'll be right back.
Genuine Drafts 1992 IndyCar champion Bobby Rahal. When we said he was flying, we weren't lying.
Tire foam protectant from Armor All. One spray, and even old tires look great. Kind of makes you wish we made car foam. Tire foam from Armor All.
Two for the price of one.
This place.
All right, here's the deal. You buy one croissant sandwich at a regular price, get the second one for free. Does that sound good?
Sounds great.
I love this place.
You ever tried to talk?
I'm a wheel watcher. I'm a wheel watcher.
Want to go for a spin?
I'm a wheel watcher. I'm a wheel watcher.
Years is America's favorite game. Join the celebration.
Wheel of Fortune, weeknights at 7.
It's America's game.
I used to exercise every day after work, but I can't anymore. I have HIV disease, and I need all my strength to keep working for as long as I can. When the day comes that I won't be able to work anymore, I know Social Security will be there for me.
Don't wait to find out about disability benefits. Call now to arrange a confidential appointment at your nearest Social Security office.
Things moving.
Yeah. My thanks to Richard Price, also LL Cool J, and Marilu Henner. Good night, everybody.